Big one. What? My hand's shaking. I am. I'm trying to see if there's people up there. I don't see people, it's just an incredible amount of smoke.
But the plane had crashed into there.
It is spreading. There's only one fire truck right now. They're gonna have to get planes and drop water onto it. Because it's so high up. Oh, really? You heard someone talking to you, said it's plain? Oh my God, Lily's going to daycare there. Hold on, there's a call waiting. Hello? Hi. Oh my God. Do you see this? Oh, so they've got it on TV. Oh my God, I have it on. Oh, me too. I thought it was as well. This build. Oh, you're right. Thank you.
they said?
Really? I think it's all about the World Trade Center. Oh my God!
It was like a military plane.
It was a military plane. People are running away. Oh my God, we just saw it happen. Where's Bob? Oh my God. Babe, are you there?
It's we're okay.
Yeah, they're attacking the World Trade Center, not us.
Where are they coming from?
From the south.
From the south?
Yeah.
The same building you went to?
Yeah.
Right there. It just looked like it was going to come, and then it just flew so low.
It was a huge plane.
Where are they flying to?
Babe, they're going to show it to you. I'm here.
I don't understand why they don't get like jet planes. The building's collapsing. I think we're okay. Turn back on the music. Oh, did the power go off? Did we lose power? Yeah, we lost power. You won't be able to call it on the phone.
You can try. It's working.
Is it working?
Thank you. in the garage, when I drive in a ladder truck, but it came in and blew up in the garage. I'm not sure it was a ladder truck, but the truck came in and it blew up in the garage. And that was in 1993.
That's a Marriott Hotel.
People are jumping now. They're
oh my god!
Oh my god! Oh, baby, hold the leash. Oh, my God.
Come on, let's go to the other room.
Yeah. Is this dangerous?
I think it's just smoke.
There's no danger about the
buildings. Is the air conditioner turned off in the room? And the windows closed in the bedroom?
People near the area are in an absolute frenzy situation. The entire top of the building just collapsed.
The entire building just collapsed.
Building just collapsed.
We're going to leave because the smoke is coming right at us.
Obviously, this is a devastating development. They're gone. The World Trade Center is no more. We do not know at this point the extent of injuries or casualties, how many people were in these buildings trying to get out. We've seen some.
Oh, people are running away. They're running away. What are they going to do? You guys got to run away.
Look at the plume.
All right,
let's go to
ABC
News right now.
I think it's going to be blown away. No, it's the wind is being blown away.
It's horrific, incredible. Not to be believed. Tuesday morning, you are looking at live pictures from the World Trade Center where just a few minutes ago, within the last minute actually, the second Twin Tower collapsed. Just to recap, if you're just joining us, around 8:42 Eastern time this morning here in New York City, a plane crashed into the right Twin Tower of the World Trade Center, about 2 feet away up the building, leaving a huge gaping hole, a huge fire, and tons of billowing smoke. About 25 minutes later, a second jet, believed to be a 727 or 737, then crashed from a second twin.
All these people running away.
Yeah. But you know, this happens every day, right, in the Middle East? You think to yourself, how lucky we are. We've never had this horrible
thing. So true. Before. You're right.
And just imagine living. Masaki went through all of this during the war. All his houses, you know, bombed. And
Oh, really? You know, this is the documentarian in me that feels like I need to record this.
You have to do that again. Just think.
Oh, look at like all the ashes. It looks like it's snowing.
Mm-hmm.
There's people. Getting onto the west side, no, onto the walkway. It's just all smoke. Of the World Trade Center building.
I'm just thinking people. Just the body parts, that's what I'm thinking to myself.
Oh, God.
Hey, guys, how you doing?
Oh, my God.
I'm just so sad.
I know.
Me too. Yeah, I'm just thinking there for the next week.
Yeah.
I'm just saying, thank you, God. But I'm just saying, as soon as you thank God, you realize that other people are just so. Absolutely
devastated.
So it's said to forget it, you know, later on I might try and go to hospitals.
Okay,
so if there's anything I can do to help,
and
everything
else, I have a feeling that the only thing is that it's just going to be so hard to move around. I think you're just
If there's anywhere I can walk to that they have a hospital.
But even walking around, it's just a disaster.
fast because I've got no man's land out there.
Well, I'm not going to do anything that's, you know, that adds to the misery. So I'm glad you got home earlier.
Yeah.
Brigitte.
God. Oh, my God.
So you said on the beach, did you see that movie?
No. What was it?
The nuclear war.
Oh, God, I'm glad I didn't. It's just smoke.
And we felt the whole ground, the whole building shook.
In fact, our cameraman even put one of the captains in his car and drove him down to a command post. The people that you're seeing here are pretty much all emergency workers. Many of them I've seen in the last 2 to 3 minutes, quite frankly, are coming out of here. Remember this, these are professionals. They're coming out of there looking literally stunned, in shock, many of them. Struggling for breath. Obviously, in serious distress, breathing problems are the biggest problem for those who manage to make it safely out of the...
Oh my God, there's no more World Trade Center.
You can't see much more than a block south of me right now. And the World Trade Center probably stands about 10 blocks south of where I am at this moment. And as you can see now, the dust is beginning to pick up here. It really depends on which way the wind blows as to whether or not we get heavy dust or not. But at this point...
all the ground with all the ash.
Yep.